The end of life journey is something that we need to plan for. It is not something that just happens and everything will fall into place. And unfortunately, what I'm noticing with my clients and my patients is that they are not planning well. They're not doing the things that they need to do to have an experience that is meaningful and supportive at the end of life. If you were planning a trip 6 months from now, you would make sure your paperwork was ready. You would make sure your insurance, your home, your bills, your pet was looked after. Why wouldn't you do the same for your final destination, your final journey? People don't think about these things because of anxiety, or they don't want to burden their loved ones. Even people that know that they are going to die because they've been given a terminal diagnosis will not have those conversations because they don't want to worry their loved ones. They do not want to add anxiety. And their loved ones are not open to having those conversations because it's difficult and they don't want to lose hope. But planning for your end of life, having those conversations, doesn't mean that you're living without hope. It is too often that I see people with precious time, a few weeks left, having to deal with paperwork, having to deal with the logistics of dying, having to deal with all the things that bog them down instead of having quality time with their loved ones. I just wanted to share that as a way to invite people to think about their end-of-life journey. Who do they want around them? How do they want to be supported? Where do they want to be? And hopefully they can continue to have these thoughts and dialogue around that, so that when we arrive, all of us at that destination, we are well prepared, we are supported, we know what we need and want, and we can be fully present.